Good morning, students. Today we will be starting with our fourth chapter, that is Living Together. Now let's listen first what the story is about to teach us. Let's listen. At a wedding party, the drums are beating aloud. Listen carefully. Can you hear a violin and the soft notes of a piano? How beautiful they all sound together. The drum, the violin, and the piano are all musical instruments making different sounds. When played together, they make beautiful music. This is called harmony. If even one of these instruments falls silent, the music will be less beautiful. So now in this chapter, we are learning that living together. Now, over here, example, a very beautiful example is given. Whenever we go to any party, we listen to melodious music. Now, why is that so melodious? Because it is a combination of the voice or beautiful sound of all different musical instruments. Even if one is not played out of all of them, the music will not be as melodious as it is. Like musical instruments, plants also teach us that we cannot do everything by ourselves. We need each other. Read the story of a plant from Africa who teaches us how to live and care for one another. So now in this chapter, we are going to learn how do we live together, because obviously we cannot live alone. We need people to help and to need each other. We need someone or all other people. Now let us read the story. Learning from plants. In the African flatlands, grew a little plant with four leaves. The leaves were happy together. They shared their food and water. They talked and laughed. Sometimes they even play hide and seek when there was a breeze. So now what we are learning, there is this plant, a little plant in the African flatlands, means in the African place, in the land of Africa, there is this beautiful little plant. How many leaves does it have? It has four leaves, and they are all living happily together. They share their food and water, they talk and laugh, and also they play hide and seek. When there is a beautiful breeze of air, a cold breeze, at that time they play hide and seek because they are moving side by side. One day, the biggest leaf was in a bad mood. "I won't share the water with you," he said. He blocked off the water supply coming from the roots. Two other leaves. So now, can you see this big leaf over here? One day, that big leaf was in a very bad mood. What did it do? It told that I will not share the water with any of you. And then it blocked the water supply which was coming from the roots, so that other leaves will not get water. The other leaves were thirsty and sad. Obviously, even if we won't drink water for long, we will also be thirsty. In the same way, these leaves, the other three leaves, were also very thirsty and sad. The next day, he said, "I won't share the food with you anymore." He blocked off the food supply which the roots were sending them. Now, next day, what happened? He stopped the food supply also. The other leaves were now thirsty and hungry. So now the leaves, they were thirsty as well, they were hungry also. Now what to do? Now see, let us see what happened next. Then slowly they began to dry up. One day they all died. The big leaf was happy. Now I can have all the food and water to myself, he thought. So slowly, obviously, without food and water, no one can survive. What happened? Slowly they dried up and all the three leaves, they died. The big leaf was happy. Now I can have all the food and water to myself. Then what did the big leaf think? It thought that now I can have all the water and food that the roots are providing by myself. But then he found that he too was dry and thirsty. He too was hungry. What had happened? The plant was dying. So the roots were also dying. So what happened here? Because of the other three leaves dying, what happened after they were dead? The whole plant started to die, because of which the root, it could not provide food and water to that one leaf, because the roots were also dying. They stopped sending food or water to the leaves. By being selfish, the big leaf had cut off the food and water supply to himself also. He was well and alive only as long as the other leaves were well and alive. When they died, he began to die too. An African folktale. So, what happened over here? When we become selfish, we also face the problems and difficulties. Why? Because if we are not thinking about someone else, then we will also face bad experiences. That is the same what happened to the big leaf also. When other leaves died, that time, after some time when the roots are also dying, after that the big leaf also died. So what do we understand from the chapter? That we should not be selfish and we should learn to be together. We should learn to live together and think of other people also. We should not be selfish and only think of ourselves. We should also think about the problems that others would face. And if we do not do so, we will also one day face the same problem. Okay, students. So, this was the chapter number 4, Living Together. In the next class, I will be sharing with you all the question and answers of the chapter. Now, what you will do? First, you will read this chapter 2 times and then you will understand it through this video. Afterwards, in the next class, we will be writing with the question and answers. Okay, students.